Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear viewers, welcome back once again to our regular show Islam and Life, segment 2. After a short break, we'll continue our today's topic, the major sins. One of the major sins is missing salah. We'll continue the missing salah part 2. We heard some of the aspect of missing salah, and we also heard some of the importance of the punishment, important punishment about the missing salah, and we also heard some reward of having salah on time and having salah, having repentance on missing salah. We'll get some reward from Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. We'll continue on that. We'll continue from our Shaykh. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh. Welcome back once again. Please, I would like to invite you to continue the topic.
Can we continue with the questions as well?
Yeah, of course. We have some questions, as you know. I would like to also invite our audience. Dear audience, you can call us and put your questions to our given number at the screen. It's 0207-096-0405. The number has given at the screen. You can call us and put your questions forward, and our Sheikh will answer them accordingly. And we also have some questions, and our Sheikh will answer them accordingly, inshallah. Yes, Sheikh.
And you can also mention for Facebook as well.
Yes, of course. Jazakallah, Sheikh. And we received some questions through Facebook, and also our Facebook Live is going on. If you are on your way, if you're going somewhere, you can also join with us through Facebook. Jazakallah khairan. It's in IQRA Bangla Facebook page. Jazakallah khairan. Please.
Jazakallah, barakallah, mashallah, barakallah. Jazakallah for the updates. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected viewers, so as we are saying, as Allah Azza wa Jalla never creates a deadlock, Allah Azza wa Jalla grants chance to everybody. Those have missed salah after Iman, it doesn't mean that they are going to thrown into the hellfire. Allah gives them chance. Allah says those return and they renew their faith and they practice good deeds and they continue with their salah. Allah Azza wa Jalla has said that فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَا يُزْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. They are the people who will be entering their paradise. Allahu Akbar. وَلَا يُزْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا, and nothing will be decreased from their rewards. Allahu Akbar. Nothing will be decreased from their rewards. So whatever they have done as good deeds after having the faith, Allah Azza wa Jalla, for each and every good deed they have done, Allah Azza wa Jalla will give them the rewards in the hereafter. And then Allah also talks about جَنَّاتُ وَعَدْرِنِ الَّتِي وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَانُ عِبَادَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ وَعْدُهُ مَأْتِيَّ. Allah Azza wa Jalla has said these people who used to miss Salah and they realize that they are making a crime against Allah, making a mistake against Allah, okay? They repent to Allah Azza wa Jalla, they renew their Iman, they practice good deeds. Allah Azza wa Jalla saying Allah will enter them into paradise as well. Subhanallah. This is the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He has for the entire creation and mainly for the humanity and mainly for the believers. Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, Jannat wa Adn. Allah also mentions the name of the Jannah which they will be dwellers of. Allah said that they will be residing in a Jannah which is known as Jannah Adn. They will be residing in it. Wa'ada ar-Rahmanu 'ibadahu bil ghayb. Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, Allah, the most merciful, has made a promise to His servant. Allahu Akbar. Allah, the most merciful, has made a promise to His servant that He will enter them into paradise. And then Allah Ta'ala has said, Bil Ghaib, that the servant has not seen that. But Allah Azza wa Jalla has made a promise to him. إِنَّهُ كَانَ وَعَدُهُ مَأْتِيَّ. Verily, the promise of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will definitely come. So whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes a promise, my brothers and my sisters, there is no doubt about it. It is definitely going to happen. It is definitely going to come. Allah azza wa jalla, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادِ. Allah azza wa jalla never goes against His promise. Allah azza wa jalla does whatever He wants. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. He has power over everything. So whatever promise Allah azza wa jalla has made, Allah will definitely fulfill it. So those people miss their salah. Allah is saying, don't worry. Just repent. Renew your Iman and continue with the good deeds. Three things only. Repent to Allah Azza wa Jalla, continue, renew your Iman, continue with the good deeds. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, these are the same people who were disobeying Allah Azza wa Jalla. They will become beloved to Allah Azza wa Jalla, such beloved that Allah will enter them into paradise. And Allah gives the visiting card as well. Allah says, they will be the dwellers of Jannatul Adn. Allahu Akbar. A Jannah, a paradise known as Jannatul Adn. And it's definitely going to come because Allah Azza wa Jalla does not go against His promise. Allah Azza wa Jalla, whatever He has promised, it is definitely going to come. Now, my brothers and my sisters, as far as Salah is concerned, we have to remember that Salah is according to the plan of Allah we have to do. Okay? Because Salah is a command. And as I said earlier on in the first segment, that once you have accepted the authority, then you have to go according to the plan of the authority. You can't do things on your own. You have to go according to the authority. So Allah Azza wa Jalla has made Salah compulsory for us. Okay?
JazakAllah Shaykh, we'll continue. We have a caller on the line. Let's take the call. Assalamu alaikum, caller.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum assalam. Yes.
Can I speak to the Shaykh?
Yes, please. Carry on, brother.
Request. Could you. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh.
Walaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I would like to ask you when people die, like Sakrat, can you explain how it's painful for a Sakrat?
Okay, inshallah. Barakallah. MashaAllah.
Do you have any other question, brother?
No, that's one question.
Our Shaykh will answer. Shaykh, should we answer that immediately? Yes, please.
JazakAllah. The brother has asked a very nice question, that when prior to death, when people pass that time, which in the term of the hadith is known as sakrat, that the moments before the death is taking place on a person, how painful that is. In order to understand, those people who have seen people dying, they can realize, or they have seen by themselves, that how painful that situation is. A person is screaming, shouting, turning his face around, turning his body around, and then he's trying to hide. And many a times people who are sinful, they try to hide their face with the pillow and the things they have around them because of the horrific situation and the things they see from the unseen, from the life of the barzakh, from the life of the hereafter, from the life of the grave. Therefore, this position at the time is very horrific, it's very scary, it's very dangerous. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she explains that in a hadith, that she says that if somebody tells me that somebody had a very light death, I want actually pay attention towards that because of what pain I have seen on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha saying, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, despite being the most beloved servant of Allah, despite being the Sayyidul Awwalina wal Akhirin, the leader of the whole of the universe, the pain Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam had to go through, despite observing that, if someone else tells me that he had a very light death, I don't actually pay attention towards that because of observing things on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In the hadith of Shama'il al-Tirmidhi, Imam al-Tirmidhi rahmatullahi alayhi narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam at the time of death, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had a bowl of water with the cold water. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would often put his hand inside that bowl and wipe his forehead. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would say, Inna lil mawti la sakarat. Verily the mawt has a pain, it has a sakarat, it has a pain. And in the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to say, Allahumma a'inni ala sakaratil mawt wa ghamarati. Wa Allah, please support me in the time of the pain of the death and wa ghamarati, and the concern and the worrying and the horrific position of the time of the death. So therefore, as far as the sakarat and the pain prior to the death is concerned, it's true, it happens. May Allah Azza wa Jalla protect all of us. However, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make that sakarat a light for anybody, Allah Azza wa Jalla can make it as well. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving somebody sakarat, it doesn't mean that he's a bad person. Because what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often intends is that Allah gives the sakarat pain, but Allah azza wa jalla removes all the difficulties and calamities to come in the grave and in the life in the hereafter. Therefore, Allah azza wa jalla, just little bit of tap in the world in the time of sakarat, Allah purifies that person for, so the next stages to come, they all can become easy for him. I hope you're not scared.
No.
Barakallah. Right.
Okay, of course, it's a reminder for us. It's
of
a reminder for us.
JazakAllah.
Yes, we'll continue with the topic about the missing salah.
So my brothers and my sisters, as Allah Azza wa Jalla is the authority, therefore He did not just made the salah compulsory in a way that we can do it according to our own desire, own style, own time, own everything. No. We have to pray salah in the way prayed by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray as you have seen me pray. Therefore we pray according to how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed. And we pray according to when Allah made the salah compulsory upon us. It's not that 11 o'clock I wake up from sleep, may Allah protect, and then pray my salah. No. we have to pray our salah according to the right timings, because Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, "Inna salata kanat ala al-mu'minina kitaban mawquta," Surah An-Nisa, verse 103. Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, "Verily Allah has made salah prescribed upon the believers in the due time." Okay, in the nominated time. So we have to pray our salah in the designated time, designated by Allah Azza wa Jalla, okay, which is Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, and Isha. These are the five times we have to pray our salah, and that is the time prescribed by Allah Azza wa Jalla. Now comes the question that we are praying for Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allah is promising us that He will give us Jannah, which is Jannatul Firdaus. Allah will make us the inheritors of Jannatul Firdaus, the dwellers of Jannatul Firdaus. Okay, fair enough. Alhamdulillah, good. But physically in the world, as cash, what rewards we're going to have? Because as human is concerned, human is very much fortunate regarding the things going to happen to him cash right now.
Yeah.
He thinks less about tomorrow. He wants to have it cash right now, okay? Like we say, live. Yeah, we have to have it live right now, yeah. Okay? So what am I going to get by praying for Allah Azza wa Jalla five times daily? Allah Azza wa Jalla mentions in the Quran as well. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Surah Al-Ankabut, verse number 45, "Inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar." Verily, salah prevents a person from al-fahsha, from all those things which are immodest, all those things which are naturally not suitable for people, all those things which naturally people dislike. Salah prevents people from those things. Okay? Wal munkar, and all those things which are considered as sin and a crime in the society, salah prevents a person from it. So if a person sincerely, properly fulfills the command of Allah Azza wa Jalla and he prays five daily prayers. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying the five daily prayers will prevent him from immodesty. Those things which is against the modesty. Okay? Those things which is against the Arabic term, in the term of hadith, he says al-haya. If a person sees anything which is abnormal, anything which is against the good conduct, the feeling he has inside him, that is known as, or inside her, that is known as al-haya. Okay? So Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying that salah prevents a person from al-fahsha, anything which is immodest. Salah prevents a person from it. And the second one Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, wal-munkar. Anything which is considered a crime against Allah, or anything which is a crime against the society, which is known as antisocial behavior. A person will prevent himself from those things by salah.
Jazakallah, Shaykh. I think we have a caller on the line. Inshallah. Let's take the call. Assalamu alaikum, caller.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I want to ask Shaykh,
yes,
do you know how we start praying? So, Allahu Akbar, and then should I pray, read Subhanakallahumma or Inni Wajjahtu first?
Okay,
Jazakallah, sister. Do you have any other question?
Do you know he said how Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, follow him? But do you know the four madhab said, read that way and read that way. So who should I follow?
Okay.
Jazakallah, sister. Thank you very much for your wonderful questions. I think it's very important and very related to our today's topic. Yes, Shaykh, please.
Barakallah. Jazakallah, sister, for the beautiful, nice two questions, mashallah. The first one is, after saying takbir-e tahrima, what du'as should I recite? So after saying takbirat tahrima, a person can recite Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik wa tabarak asmuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruk. It's also in hadith, sahih hadith. Similarly, a person, if they want, they can recite Inni wajjahtu wajhiya lilladhi fatara as-samawati wal arda hanifan wa ma ana minal mushrikeen. Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. La sharika lahu wa bidhalika umirtu wa ana awwalul muslimin. If a person wants to recite, he can. But preferably this Inni wajjahtu, which is known as tawjih, is for the optional prayers. Okay, for the farad compulsory prayers, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would often recite Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik wa tabarak asmuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruk, and then he would begin the recitation of the Holy Quran. Similarly, after the takbirat tahrima, if a person wants to recite, they can recite Allahumma ba'id bayni wa bayna khataya kama ba'adta bayna al-mashriqi wal-maghrib wa naqini min ad-dhunubi kama yunqa thawb al-abyad min ad-danas, etc., etc. If a person wants to recite that as well, that is also allowed. It came in the hadith. However, preferable is to recite in the optional prayers, not in the farad salah. In the farad salah, Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, and then Surah Fatiha, and then continue with the qiraat. Now the sister asked the second question that I said, Sallu kamara ayatumuni usalli. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said that pray as you have seen me pray. Absolutely right, sister. We pray our salah exactly the way Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam comes. Now sister says, where did the madhab come from then? The answer to this is the madhab explains the procedure of the salah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Like you have a question, you are asking me, you have the concern regarding what to recite after takbirat tahrima. So you are watching this program and you said, okay, let's ask the Shaykh. He's quite knowledgeable, okay, mashallah, in converted commas. Let's ask him. So you ask me for the answer, so we have given you the answer, okay? Now, Quran and Hadith, they are the raw materials, okay? And there is thousands of verses of the Holy Quran, and there is hundreds of thousands of ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As a layman, I don't know everything. So a person who knows, he may give me a conclusion, he may give me an answer. And Allah says in the Quran, if you don't know, fasalu ahla dhikr in kuntum la ta'lamun. Ask the people of the knowledge if you don't know. So we have seen these people of the madhab, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, they are the great knowledgeable people of this ummah. This is why the entire ummah calls them the four great imams. If the four great imams are agreed on an issue, it's like the consensus of the ummah. The entire ummah is united on this issue. You are not allowed to go out of that. Okay, so because they are the great knowledgeable scholars of our time, they have explained the Quran and Hadith properly, and in converted comma, they have made them piece of cake for everybody. So easy for everybody to understand Quran and Hadith. Therefore, we take the madhab. So madhab is not against Hadith or Quran. Madhab, in fact, my sister, very simply understand it like that. Explanation of the Quran and Hadith. Explanation of the Quran and Hadith. I hope you understood the answer, inshallah.
Jazakallah, Shaykh. Thank you very much. I think not only the sisters who questions this question, the others also be, the other audience will be enlightened. Yes.
This is the benefit of we kept the line open in our IQRA TV, taking all these questions. Many times people ask very wise questions. Okay? And because of a beautiful question, many thousands, hundreds of thousands of people they are watching, they get the answer. So a person asks a nice question, and inshallah, if with the will of Allah, and a satisfactory answer is given, millions of people can benefit. And as you have seen, like our answers, mashallah, from not only from this TV, any other TV, people who watch, and then they go to YouTube, people make the little clips, and they put them in their Facebook and then YouTube, so they can become viral. Our mashallah, Many people they have watched it and benefited. And I have seen on IQRA Bangla page that more than 50 people have shared it. Mashallah. So many people have understood it, alhamdulillah. So this is the whole purpose of having the live question and answers that people do ask, and then the answer is given, inshallah, with the will of Allah according to Quran and Sunnah. And then thousands of the viewers in many of the social media, they watch and they benefit from it.
Into that also, we do record our program, and if a person or any audience just search our today's date and the name of the program, they can find it on YouTube
as well.
Straight away. So
and it's repeated as well.
It's repeated as well.
Mashallah. So alhamdulillah, there's no chance we can miss the program. So it's repeated, it's in YouTube, it's going live on Facebook, and then after that, mashallah, many people they do many things. Alhamdulillah.
Jazakallah, okay. Thank you. We'll continue the topic, and it's time for a short break.
Allahu Akbar.
We have to go for a break.
Jazakallah.
Viewers, it's time for a short break, and we'll come back shortly. Please stay with us, and please enlighten your knowledge with the lectures of our Sheikh. We'll continue after the short break. Jazakallah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.